Hello, everyone. Welcome back to Demon Souls. This is Kay. I am on my way back to have a rematch against these gargoyle bosses, the Maneaters. Which means, well, it's a pretty straightforward run, except for this one guard on the stairs. Could be a problem. Let's make sure we've got this spell on. Wear the thief ring for this. That one guy on a really kind of, you know, the narrow and railless stairway that makes this little bit dangerous. Everything else you can just run right by. So here we go. So there's just the one boss at the start, and I get a second one, so I want to kill this one as quick as possible, so maybe be a bit more aggressive. Two-hand the weapon. Nope, I don't know what that is, but don't do it. Don't you fall off there. Oh God! It's like Moonlight Butterfly territory. Where'd it go? Where'd it go? There it is. I almost have it. No! Darn it. Yes! No! Oh, God. Oh! Wow. Oh, that was the one-time revival. Saved my life. That's what it was. Oh, which one's hurt? Which one's hurt? Be you, be you, be you. It's not you. It's the other one. One-time revival just kicked in there, I see. On the hit that would have killed me. Alright. Welp. Here we go again. That seems to be the way to go. If I get a little bit luckier on positioning on that first one, I could theoretically just kill it outright before the second one gets to me. Oop, he dropped something. You. Okay, let's throw on this ring. Oh, I can't. Well, I could, but I would have to heal myself when I put the cling ring back on. I take off the ring of devout prayer. Presumably, if I take off the Ring of Devout Prayer, it, like, automatically unattunes one of my spells. He's turned his back on me. Get him! Get him! Go. Bebop and Rocksteady, take three. knock me off that ledge. Come on, get that one more hit in. Oh, that's the wrong one again. Damn it. Where'd the first one go? Okay, they're both down there. Which one's hurt? Hopefully you. Nope. Hopefully you. Dare fly away. Oh, come on. Jeez. Ugh. I was sure I had the right one on that first swing. They pulled the old switcheroo on me. It looks like I'm holding a cube on my shoulder. Like a Fez cube. Hexahedron. Alright. Well, it looks like we're doing this run a whole bunch. Definitely didn't kill that enemy. It will live. It will live to tell its grandkids about the horrors it experienced on this day. Nope. Nope. Death. Wait, what just happened? Oh, my spell saved me again. Handy spell. Somebody didn't have one-time revival. Gotta get this extra hit on this one before the other one arrives. Oh my god, come on. Don't you do this. There we go. Got it. Now I can take my time with this one. Here. falling off the ledge. Don't do it. See these? These are ledges. Don't fall off of them. Soul we get from them. Mixed demon soul. That's the stairs up. Still can't believe Saint Urbane didn't say anything to me after I killed Saint Astraea. Or Saint Astraea. What do you give me for... you don't give me anything for the mixed demon soul.
Yes, I see. I certain... But you must remember this.
Well, if you update your wares, I might buy more stuff from you.
Oh, thank God. I'm better.
It's my family. They're an odd bunch. Mixed demon soul? Anything? Nothing. Must be used for a weapon. One of these videos I'll have to kind of strip down and take all of my weapons to Ed again to see what I can make that's new.
I am fully prepared. I can still be patient.
Any way you can guess, like what weapon is likely to be upgraded with a mixed demon soul? Like, the gargoyles didn't really use, maybe like a halberd? Because gargoyles had halberds in the subsequent games.
But perhaps our age.
Alright, let's grab another point of faith. Let's use all of our souls. Be right back. And there. That was 43 souls I just used. Portable souls.
Thou seek then ta- I keep the soul of the mind key to.
We still only got like 2 levels. Oh, there we go.
Drawn from its vessel.
Awesome. My extra miracle slot.
Granted, so the world art thou done?
Which means... Take off the cling ring because I'm alive. I can take off this ring because I don't need the extra slot. So let's put on the... Generator's ring. Fragrant ring. Be all sorts of recuperating. I think the next thing I'm going to do is see if I can free Lord Riddiel, or Lord Rydell, from his cell in the Tower of Latria. did I ever miss? I just missed wholly and utterly. There's a black phantom over there. Guess I didn't get to him in time. Looks like we're fighting this guy. I have a feeling he's not going to care to talk to me. Oh god, that does a whole lot of damage. Do very much to him. Right through my shield, too. It's the last large healing grass I have on me. There's one-time revival saving my butt again. Oh, I need to get more healing grasses equipped. Oh wait, I'm not on the second floor anymore, am I? Oh yeah. Yeah, I am. Kind of disconcerting not knowing where he is. Treasure's over there, I don't know how to get to. Ha, much better. Go, go, Dark Shield. God. I was getting the backstab. Oh, I was so worried that octopus guard there was gonna sneak up behind me and shoot me with magic. Phosphorescent pole. Pole weapon, 110 magic damage, its intelligence scaling. A long rod inlaid with a blue jewel that emits phosphorescent light. Bladeless and lightweight, it is magically enhanced and slowly regenerates the user's health. Lord Ridiel of the Outskirts took this from the Witch of the Sky. What floor am I on now? I have to go down here. Out here. Oop. I'm gonna try whacking at these rocks with the phosphorescent pole. This one's here. And the twirly attack. How do I get over? Onto that ledge over there. Is there a doorway there? No, that's just a wall. Is there a break up there that I have to drop down from? Somewhere on the... That would be the third floor. A break in the floor there? Nope. Yeah, that looks like a solid walkway above it. Clearly you can get over there. Is this like a tenancy thing? Whoa, what happened? What happened to my world tenancies? Huh. Those are no longer bright, in the least. Okay. Things have changed. Something is different. And I don't have a... Oh yeah, I do have evacuate memorized still. Okay, let's get out of here. Oh god, my worlds are all dark. They're super dark. I guess I don't have to worry about dying in human form anymore. So... Maybe getting the phosphorescent pole makes everything dark. Maybe I should return to some of the worlds I've already done white on. Like World 5, World 4, or World 2. Let's do World 2. We'll go through World 2 in dark. Oh man, that was... I was not expecting that. Did kind of take me by surprise. Because like every time I've been logging in, it's been like... It's always been sort of pushing them to white. Not today. Man, this shield has 100 physical and 100. It doesn't have the same hit resistance. This one has a better hit resistance. But, my god. Probably needs colorless again to upgrade, I expect. But, what a great shield. So we are on the lookout for anything different. Different. Really love the view from this loop. Don't miss our stop. Okay, so enemies are supposed to be like more badass in this dark tendency. Tail waving. Ooh, what is that? it's putting me down right in front of it. I don't want to be right in front of it. Let's hop onto this and then off of here. What the crap is this? Boat in monster form. Holy crap. No. Man, is that a colorless demon? Is that what a colorless demon is? It had color. Or are they saying the soul is colorless? Oh, that is great. Super. Although, either Moonlight Sword plus 2 or maybe Dark Silver Shield plus 1. Keep going through the level. Ooh, crescent axe. Did I get one of those already? long-handled large axe with a crescent blade, the weapon of the fat ministers who show faint smiles. With quite a bit of weight, it shows the unbelievable power of the ministers who wield them. Who wailed them. A sure sign of Kay's descent into demonhood. And if I'm not a full-fledged demon by now, not sure what else I need to do. I mean, I have like all the souls. What are we gonna find in dark? So there was that like colorless demon soul thing. That was new. But surely there's more than that. Not that that wouldn't be enough. I mean, that's a great item to get, but like in white there was like you got like a quest. Here. Still looks closed off. Oh, there's a new guy. Interesting that he aggroes me from farther away, too. Right up, get your Moonlight Greatsword. Ah, there's one. There's two. I overestimate the length of this sword. There we go, finally. Imagine they put in like a Black Phantom version of the boss. That's nice. Drop a rock and then hop down and get hit by a mace. That's how that goes. Ooh, there we go. Guys are good for upgrade materials. They're like miniature violent crystal lizards. So big. Exploring it takes a long time. It's not just that it's big, it's that it's big and, like, confusing, those tunnels down there. Still there. Now don't have the sword out. Whoa! It's not the same guy. Or it is the same guy, but he's gone bad. Ooh, that's a fast spell. Can I block it? No, it hits me through the... Oh, because it's fire damage. It's not magic damage. Oh, God! Oh, my. That world is going to be darker now. Is that guy going to disappear? Or, no, wait. Never mind. I have that backward. The world is already dark. I don't have to worry about it being darker. I just have to go fight that guy. One-time revival spell on. And now we need the Kling Ring. You know what? What we need is one of these. That spell he uses out of the gate. Oh god, that little fireball is so fast. I should get the fire shield. What I should do. I should get that purple shield. Trying to push him off the ledge. Nope. Oh, God, I couldn't get a push off. He just comboed me. into oblivion. I guess pushing him off the ledge probably isn't the greatest idea. Well, except if I push him off that ledge, then I can get down to the bottom and gather anything he drops. So it would be a good tactic. But better tactic is probably to get that shield. Since the world's already dark, it doesn't really matter if I get back here, right? I assume. Except I've killed a whole bunch of black phantoms, so it might not be dark anymore. I've also died while human a few times, which could counterbalance that. It's hard. Yes, go over there. Go over there. Keep backing up. Keep backing up. No, get out of the corner. Yes! Die in the fall. Okay. Now. How do I get down there? How do I get onto that platform? Okay, from here, is it? Can I get to the other side from here? From right here. There we go. We have collected Talisman of Beasts. Which I will look at here and then cut the video. Talismans would be weapons. Talisman of Beasts. Is I can't really tell what the magic adjust is, I think because I don't have the required intelligence. This scales B faith, this scales C intelligence, C faith. C intelligence for talisman? An old wooden amulet resembling the old beast. It can utilize both miracles and magic. Oh, interesting. The symbol of God was no more than an image of the old beast. Symbol of God. Was no more than an image of the old beast. So is the old beast the old one? Like, is that the demon? Symbol of God. They're saying, so the symbol of God, I guess, would be, well, either, like, an icon of God, or maybe they're saying, like, the, what this game is calling the revelations of God, like, the, the artifacts that kind of reveals God's existence. Or the image of the beast. That doesn't sound very good. That's sounding like, there is no God. Which actually kind of seems to be a theme of the series as a whole. Like, there's been a lot of points where it's like, the gods are really just the really powerful, like, demon souls, basically. Like, all of the gods in Dark Souls, like, those giants, that family of giants, like Gwyn and his family, they were gods because they had the power that they took from the first flame. Like, they weren't really gods, they were just... But they were worshipped as gods, which I guess makes them gods. Alright. Well, that is an interesting point to end on. I will see you in the next video, guys. Thanks for following. Thanks for watching. Keep the secret. Till next time. Later.